Hello, welcome to 9design 3D. In this video, we will make some basic type Glock or pistol models for our games and animations. Let's go to the tutorial. First, you can search some images from the Google. If you want, you can search as the Glock Gen 3 or Gen 5 type guns. I will make some mix up for the different pistol types with the different species, but we will make really basic and simple gun for ourselves. First, we will add our image reference as a side look. I downloaded this, but if you want, you can get some another type. After that, you can decrease your opacity and check unselectable. For the modeling our gun, we will start with the cube. With the Shift A, you can add some cube. Change your view to the wireframe mode. Z to wireframe is the shortcut. You can scale some vertices, and with the Ctrl R, you can add extra loop cuts, and with the G to move your vertices matching your reference image. I will make simple modeling type. Choose top of the vertices and E to extrude them up in the Z axis. For the back face, you can choose this and E to extrude in X axis. After that, with the adding extra loop cut with Ctrl R, you can move some of your vertices and give a smooth shape for your gun. I am using simple modeling method with this, you can use them. For the button face, you can press I to inset and after that scale, E to extrude it down. For the trigger holder parts, move some vertices and continue to make same modeling process. I will make this video half explained and half time lapse. You can see from the left bottom for our screencast. When I'm making an extra thing for the different type from my modeling process, I will slow down these parts. After all you give shape, we will add a cube again for the top part of our gun with the 1 to front view and 3 to side view. You can change it from the numpad. Again, in the wireframe, we will move our vertices in x-axis. You can add extra loop cuts for the top and bottoms. Give some smooth shape or if you want, you can give some bevel with the Ctrl B. For the some edges, I will E to extrude the back vertices, actually back faces, and you can scale in Z axis 0, some of the tidy up vertices and edges. For the giving extra smoothness, you can add middle of it loop cut and scale some of the side vertices like this. For the smooth other parts, you can choose your edge lines and Ctrl B to bevel them. For the sharp edges, you can use this bevel method. After that, shade smooth and check your auto smooth. We will add some subdivision modifier it later. For the trigger parts, you can scale them in Y axis with your edge lines. Let's add some trigger for this. We will use cube again. In Z to wireframe, E to extrude some vertices to the down, add extra loop cuts, and give a shape for your trigger. Again, Ctrl B to bevel some of your edge lines. This is your model. You don't have to make all the same parts of your Glock or other pistol reference image. You can give different shapes and add different species for yourself. I'm adding an edge line middle of this trigger and delete half of the vertices. After that, you can add some mirror modifier and don't forget to check your clipping. For these vertices, you can G to move in Y axis them. It will be tied up like this. For the bottom part, you can I to inset again, E to extrude them down this space, adding extra loop cut with Ctrl R. And give around the shape for bottom of your gun. Now we will add a cube for making this species part. Give a shape for this. You can follow your reference image for making this part. You don't have to make very special of it, because we will use this for our Boolean modifier. You can Shift D to duplicate it for the X and size. Ctrl J to join them together. Ctrl A all transform. Set origin to geometry with the right click. Choose your top part of gun. Add a Boolean modifier. Choose your object, these cubes. After applying your Boolean modifier with Ctrl A, as you see, it will look like this. For the bottom part, we will add some subdivision surface modifier too. You can add extra loop cut for giving sharpie and tidy edges. As you see, there are some retopo lost in here. K to knife tool, you can cut some of the vertices. You can cut some of the faces and join them together. With the knife tool, you can use it clearly and join your final vertices together. Choose this holding part faces. When your subdivision modifier active, you can I to inset a bit, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. As you see, you can give some outliner shape like this. For the adding some extra species for yourself, you can choose some faces from your gun. You don't have to follow all the reference image. You can press I to inset, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. We use this method for all our object modeling. I am making same thing for the other side. I to inset, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. For the top of the other species, I am adding a cube. You can give some scale for the top vertices, adding extra loop cuts. In object mode, we will add a mirror modifier too. Axis Y and choose as a mirror object your top gun part. Delete some faces and G to move them. But don't forget to check clipping. You can add extra details and extra species for yourself for your own gun. If you want, you can make it maybe sci-fi type. For the front rear part, you can add a cube again, scale and place it. For the front, we will add some circle. In tap to edit mode, you can E to extrude it in X axis. You can E to extrude, right click and S to scale again. And with the same process as you see from the screencast, you can give some shape from the raw part for your gun. For the making this type of Boolean part, you can Shift it to duplicate it. Close some faces with the F, inner of the circle parts. As the same method, you can choose top part of your gun, add a Boolean modifier, choose your front circular object. For the other parts, you can place it. Shift D to duplicate it and make middle of the part. For this top side part, you can add a cube again. Choose some edges, Ctrl B to bevel. Shade smooth and don't forget to check your auto smooth. We will use the same thing. The Boolean modifier. Choose these faces, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. Our gun totally will look like this. You can add extra species with the inset some faces, adding extra loop cuts when your subdivision surface modifier activated. Let's add some metal black material. Go to shading tab and after that, give a black color. increase your metallic value and decrease your roughness. After all the thing, you can add a bump note in here with Shift A. Connect your normal to normal. Add a color ramp note. Connect your color to hate. Add a noise texture. And Ctrl T, add some mapping note. With the moving your color ramp note, you can give some bump to your material. With the changing your bump strength and distance, you can give some extra species for your material. With the changing your noise texture scale, you will see something in here. But before all of this, don't forget to connect your texture's coordinate object to mapping node vector. We will change this generated. And now you can see this little species on our material. You can give this type of metallic, rusty materials maybe. Choose all of them, Ctrl L and link material. But in here there's a glitch around and we can't add any loop cut in here because we use Boolean modifier. After that it can cause a problem. With the K to knife tool you can add extra cutting edges in here. As you see we have three extra faces. But before all of this, again in tap to edit mode, with the vertex select 1, press M and merge by distance. It will remove some vertices and correct your topology like this. But as I said before, you have to optimize something on it for using in the game and animations. I am showing only how to model your basic gun with your extra species. As a basic pistol, you can add some pins or other extrusions onto it. In some different war games, as you remember, some pistols and guns models, maybe GLOCK or revolvers. If you wanna get some other type of the gun, how to model them, you can go from the top right card or under the link in description. You can find my other gun modeling videos. You can use them with modeling your own guns. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.